Hello students, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jagdeep and in this video series we are talking about indifference curve analysis. I've already made one playlist which is in Hindi and it talks about consumer equilibrium with indifference curve analysis. This is going to be the second playlist where we will be breaking down price effect, income effect, substitution effect and derivation of demand curve. All right, these lectures would be in English because a lot of my students who are regular viewers of my channel have requested me to make videos in English so that they understand what I'm teaching in the video. All right, students, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do subscribe to my channel. As I've been promising in all my Hindi videos that I will be releasing notes, quizzes and important concepts from this entire segment on my Facebook page, please go ahead and follow my Facebook page as well. You should see the link in the description box. Now, those students who do not know anything about indifference curve analysis or budget line or the rotations in budget line, please look at the videos in the description box before coming here because those are the concepts that you need to know before you understand price effect. All right? So without wasting any time further, let's get started. So when we talk about price effect, what is price effect? So price effect would refer to change in consumption of one good due to a change in its price, keeping the price of other good and the income of consumer constant, or we could say ceteris paribus. Any change in consumption that occurs in one good whenever the price of that particular good changes. All right. Now, how do we locate price effect on a diagram? Let's take a look at that. So we have this diagram where we have chocolates on y-axis, pizza slices on the x-axis, all right? AB is the budget line and we have IC, which is the indifference curve, tangent at point E, where we have quantity Q for pizza slices, all right? Now, let us say that the price of pizza slices falls, all right? So price of pizza slices falls. So when the price of pizza slices falls, that's a general common sense we should be knowing, quantity of pizza slices would go up. Why? Because consumers' ability to purchase just went up. Ability to buy increased. And when that happens, he'll be buying more of X without making any changes in the commodities listed on the y-axis. When that happens, the budget line would rotate to the right. Let us say this is how the budget line has rotated. Let's name it as AB1 and let us say this is the new indifference curve. Okay, this is IC1 and this is E1. So this point at tangency, this is the quantity Q1 that the consumer is buying for pizza slices, right? Now, if the price of pizza slices falls again, I'm sure we can guess now what will happen. We know that the quantity demanded by consumer would go up because the same reason, ability to pay has just gone up. And in that case, you would see a further rightward rotation in the budget line. Let us say this is the new budget line that has rotated and now it is called AB2 and probably let us say this is the new indifference curve called as indifference curve 2, IC2, and it is tangent at point E2. This is the quantity purchased by the consumer for pizza slices. So the movement of equilibrium from E to E1 and to E2 is what we call as price effect. When the price of commodity X fell, consumer was able to buy more of commodity X or pizza slices in our case. In this case, the budget line rotated from AB to AB1 first and from AB1 to AB2 the second time. Likewise, the quantity consumed of pizza slices which is listed on the x-axis, increased from Q to Q1 the first time and from Q1 to Q2 the second time. So the movement, let me just highlight it with a different color. So the movement from point E to E1 and E1 to E2 is the price effect. All right, students, I hope we are able to understand what price effect is. In the next video, we will take a look at PCC, which is basically this red line that I've just made. PCC, this is called as price consumption curve. We shall take a look at what PCC is and what are the different types of slopes PCC curve would have. All right. All the students who do not have enough time to learn from long videos, you can definitely go ahead and watch reels over my Instagram channel. You would be able to learn the concepts in a smaller duration as well. All right, students. So let's meet another video and learn about PCC curve. Till then, bye now. Take care.